Okay, good day guys, good day to you all. Welcome back to the Formula Sports Channel. Thanks for being here. So, as usual, we are watching, the reggae boys, for their respective clubs, their performances for their respective clubs, right, all around the world, right? And we are watching these players, and most times, if not all the times, right, I see Javain Brown play. I have to ask myself the question, why does the gaffer Theodore Tupper Whitmore, why does he not like Javain Brown? Right, I don't understand it. Right, in recent times, we have seen Javain Brown feature very little for the national team. Right, very little. And I have to ask the question, why is our best right back not playing many games for Jamaica, right? If Tupper do the right thing and it does not work out, me not have no complaints where that is concerned, right? But when I see, in my humble opinion, a vastly superior player, right, being benched, right, in terms of a player that I humbly, with the greatest of respect, believe is better than who is playing. I can't wrap my brain around it, right? If him do the right thing, and let's say, for instance, him play Javain and it doesn't work out, then me can't wrong him for that, right? But why is he not playing Javain Brown? I don't get it, and I just want to make this absolutely clear. I am not a KC old boy, right? I don't know Javain Brown, never spoken to the player, right? I am speaking from an objective standpoint. In my humble opinion, Javain Brown is the best right back and the most complete right back that the national team has. And what makes it even worse, right? Many people would agree that at right back is kind of a bit of a problem. Many people would agree, right? I mean, the mere fact that most games in recent times, as a matter of fact, probably every game in recent time the national team has played, you see a deliberate effort by the opposition to target the right-hand side of our defense, right? It can't be a coincidence, in my opinion. It just cannot be a coincidence that game in, game out, we see the right side of our defense being targeted, right? I just don't understand. In my humble opinion, I think Brown is the best and most complete right back that we have available, right? Very intelligent passing, right? His long passing is generally speaking good, right? He has vision, right? He has precision with difficult passes, right? Very direct and precise with his crosses, right? Can deliver good crosses with his weaker left foot. Like, for instance, he's playing at left wing back or left back. He can swing them in with his weaker left foot as well. The other day, I was watching a game with Javain Brown, right? And he delivered an excellent cross into the box with his weaker left foot, right? That eventually found a Vancouver player at the back post who headed it back across, and the player in the box, headed it in. But he found the player with his weaker left foot at the far post, the player who was in, free out at the far post, right? Found him, headed it across, put it back into the goal, right? So he's good with, crossing with his weaker left foot as well, right? He picks his moments to go forward well, right? He's an intelligent player, right? Tracks back well, right? Even late in games, very late in games, the player is tracking back very well, right? His defensive transition is very good, in my humble opinion, right? Good positioning on both sides of the ball on a number of plays. If not, like, most of the times, his positioning is on point. Most, like, you can't say all the times, because obviously, no one is perfect, but he is very good with his positioning on both sides of the ball, right? Excellent. Excellent in 1v1 defensive duels, right? Very intelligent when it comes to defending in 1v1 duels, right? It is very difficult to get past Javian Brown, right? He times his challenges very, very well, right? Works for the ball when he loses it, right? When he does lose it, he works hard to try and regain possession or put the player who won the ball under good pressure. He is excellent in the air. Excellent in the air. Excellent in the air, right? And he has a good long throw on him as well, right? If you notice, he takes a lot of the throw-ins for Vancouver Whitecaps' club team in Canada, right? Especially the ones in the final third, right? The only issue I have with Javian Brown, right? The only issue I have with Javian Brown is that he has on occasion shown the skill and ability, right, to get past players, right? But the issue I have with him is that, in my humble opinion, sometimes he shies away from taking on players in 1v1 situations to get in behind. Let's say, for instance, he's playing as a wing back, because he plays as a wing back for Vancouver a lot, right? There are a number of occasions where, you know, I see where he could be more direct, where that is concerned in terms of he could take the ball, you know, and run at a fullback, right, who he could isolate, right? And if he were to beat that fullback in that 1v1 duel, he could get in behind and cause problems. I have seen it, right? You know, obviously I've seen him do it, but, you know, in my humble opinion, he could do it a little bit more. Sometimes he tends to, like, you know, pass the ball, right? So, you know, sometimes, well, it's good when he tries to link up to get in behind. I don't have an issue with that. But sometimes, in my humble opinion, I realize that he kind of backs out of taking on the player 1v1, right? When, you know, in situations where he could get in behind and cause problems if he got past the fullback, you know? You know, and these situations arise especially when he's playing as a wingback, right? To be fair to him, probably it's coach's instructions. We don't know if the coach, you know, has instructed him to do it, yes or no, right? Probably the coach wants to play it safe, right, and not risk it and keep a hold of the ball. I don't know, right? But that's my only criticism of the player. But generally speaking, I think the player is the best right back that we have available to us right now, right? And that's with the greatest of respect to O'Neill Fisher, Alvis Powell and Wes Harding, right? I think that Powell and Fisher has shown issues on the defensive part of the game. And I think Harding, while he's decent going forward, he's not the best, right? I think that Javian Brown is the best right back that we have available to us, especially given the fact that he is, in my humble opinion, the most complete, right? The most complete right back that we have available to us in terms of somebody that has basically all the facets that you need in a good right back. So it baffles the mind, right? Why Theodore Tapper Whitmore keeps on giving other players like Alvis, like Fisher, and even Wes Harding, giving them the run out, but not giving Javian Brown the run out. And we saw what happened when Javian came onto the pitch in the little time that he got against Honduras. Look at that excellent, excellent low cross that he made, right? That excellent pass that he made to Andre Gray, right? What a brilliant pass it was. We saw a glimpse right there of what this player can do. You know, hopefully, in this World Cup campaign, he will get more chances later on in the campaign to prove his worth. So, guys, that's my 2 cents on this matter. Stay safe, take care, and until next time.